Question number 81. According to kinetic theory of gases, the incorrect statement is. Let's check the given statements. Statement 1 is there. Collision of gas molecules are perfectly elastic. It is a correct statement as per kinetic theory of gases. Further, particles of gas moves in all possible directions in straight line. So, if you read this kinetic theory of gases, you might be knowing that this is also a correct statement that particles of gas move in all possible directions in straight line. So, this is also correct. Further, gas molecules are considered as point masses. Yes, it is also true. And then, at a particular temperature, all molecules have same kinetic energy. This is an incorrect statement. Why this statement is incorrect? Because we are talking about the different gaseous molecules. They all have different speeds. And if they have different velocity, different speed, definitely they have different kinetic energy also. So this statement that at a particular temperature, all molecules have same kinetic energy is an incorrect statement. And on that basis, I will choose it as the correct answer for my question. Now, after this, question number 82. Question number 82 is here. The difference between heat of reaction at constant pressure and constant volume for the reaction. What is that reaction? Combustion of hexane. And this results in formation of carbon dioxide and water at 27 degrees Celsius. So simply, we first have to find out the heat at constant pressure. That is equal to delta H. We know that. Further, heat at constant volume. That is delta U. Now, what is the relation between these two? We know that delta H is equal to delta U plus delta N GRT, where delta N G represent the number of the gaseous molecules which are changed. So, final number of moles of gaseous molecules minus initial number of moles of the gaseous molecule. Now, delta H minus delta U is the difference between heat of reaction at constant pressure and at constant volume. So, this value is equal to delta N GRT and delta NG are the moles of the gaseous substances. Let's check. If you look at the given reaction, in the reactant side, there are total 9 gaseous moles, while at the product side, there are 6 gaseous moles. So, it would be 6 minus 9, this delta NG value. What about the value of R? For this case, we'll take the value of R, 8.314 further. The T value. The T value is given here, 27 degrees Celsius. So, it would be 300 Kelvin. This is the value that you will obtain in joules further. We want this value in kilojoule because all the options contain the values in kilojoule. So, this would be 3 into, it would be minus 3 into 8.314 into 300 and just multiply 10 is to the power minus 3 and this value would be in kilojoule. And finally, if you solve this, you will find out this value is minus 7.48 kilojoule. And if it is so, we can easily choose our correct answer, that is option. Question number 83. 1 mole of an ideal gas undergoes change of state from 4 liter and 3 atmosphere. Means volume and pressure is given. To 6 liter and 5 atmosphere. Again, volume and pressure is given. It means we have the specified states here in terms of volume and pressure. Further, if the change in internal energy is 45 liter atmosphere, then the change of enthalpy for the process is. So, in this case, the change in internal energy is also given. This is change in internal energy. So, this can be represented as delta U, that is 45 liter atmosphere. And here, you need to find out the change in enthalpy for the process. And we know that the relation between delta U and delta H, that is delta H is equals to delta U plus delta PV. This is the relation. And in this case, we have this delta U value, that is 45 liter atmosphere, it's given in the question, plus What is the change in pressure and the change in volume? That you can find out. P1 is given, that is 3 atmosphere. V1 is also given, that is 4 liter. And from this state, it is changing into the next state where P2 is 5 atmosphere. And this V2 is 6 liter. These values we have. Let's check the final values. P2 V2 is 5 into 6 minus P1 V1, that is 3 into 4. This would be the value, and it is 45 plus 30 minus 12. And if you solve this for the value of delta H, you will identify that this value is 45 plus 80, and this is 63 liter atmosphere. And the 63 liter atmosphere is given in option 4, and that's why my answer is option 4. And after this, it's a turn for next question. Question number 84. Enthalpy of which of the following reactions does not represent the standard enthalpy of formation? So first thing we should know here, that what is this standard enthalpy of formation? This is the enthalpy for the reaction in which one mole of the product is formed from its constituent elements in their most stable form of aggregation. So basically we have to just identify that reaction for which the standard enthalpy of formation is not equal to the reaction enthalpy. So here the first reaction is given, H2 combining with half O2 to give you H2O, one mole of H2O is formed here, and this H2 and O2, these are the most stable form of aggregation. That is why this reaction enthalpy is equal to the standard enthalpy of formation of water also. That's why it's correct. Further, H2 plus O2 is giving you 2 HBr. It means 2 moles of HBr are formed by combination of H2 and Br2. But in case of standard enthalpy of formation, we need that enthalpy change which occurs during the formation of one mole of the substance. So this reaction enthalpy is not equal to the standard enthalpy of formation of HBr. That's why I marked it wrong. Further, sulfur, rhombic sulfur we have combined with O2 to give you SO2. Yes, these two are the constituent elements of SO2, and both of these are present in their most stable form of aggregation. So for this is also the reaction enthalpy is equal to standard enthalpy of formation of SO2. That's why I marked it as correct. Further, carbon in the form of graphite you have combined with 3H2 half O2 to give you ethanol. This ethanol, one mole is formed here, and it is formed from its constituent element carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, which are present in their most stable form of aggregation. That is why this reaction also has the enthalpy that is equal to the standard enthalpy of the formation. That's why this reaction that's given in option 2 is the correct answer for this particular question. And after this, question number 85 is here. 5 moles of an ideal gas undergoes reversible expansion from 1 liter to 4 liter. So this is expansion, reversible expansion basically at 27 degrees Celsius. The work done and enthalpy change for the process respectively are. So here we need to find out enthalpy change, the first thing, and the work. Here this delta H value is equal to nCp delta T. And if this process is taking place at a constant temperature of 27 degrees Celsius, it means this delta T value is 0. And on that basis, this delta H value would be 0. Further, we need to find out the next thing, that is work done. We know that work done for the reversible process is equal to minus 2.303 nRT log V2 by V1. That V2 represent the final volume and V1 represent the initial volume. So let's place the values here. 2.303 n value. How many moles are there? Clearly given in the question. Just have a look on that. 5 moles of an ideal gas are there. And these are undergoing reversible expansion from 1 liter to 4 liter. So let's place the values. Now n is 5. R we already know, that is 8.314. And what's the temperature? That is 27 degrees Celsius. It means 300 Kelvin log. What is V2? It is expanding from 1 liter to 4 liter. So final volume is 4. Initial volume 1 liter. And just solve this for the value of W, that is minus 17289 joules. This is the value in joule, but we need answer in kilojoule. So it would be minus 17.289, or simply 17.29. That would be the value. And this is in kilojoule. Let's check our answer in the given options. If you check the given options, which include work done and enthalpy. So work done is minus 17.3 kilojoule approximately, because this expression is rounded off. So this is the answer. Let's check where this answer is given in the options. It is here in option 2, minus 17.3 kilojoule. This is the value of work done, and further 0 kilojoule for the value of enthalpy change. This is our answer. That's why I'm choosing option 2 as the correct answer. And after this, it is the turn for next question.